Hey guys, welcome back to my Wolfed Out Fallout 3 series. I am Roran. Now in this particular adventure, it's just me and Dogmeat searching for the rumors of a green paradise here in the wasteland. Now as you can see from behind us, we have discovered it. But there is a price. We are tasked to do something we don't really want to do to somebody who is a marvel against nature. So, join me on this adventure and enjoy. Well, it seems to be, it may be right here, what we're looking for. I keep on hearing reports of greenery on the radio, on GNR. Somewhere up here is a nice forestation of trees. Well, look at this. Oh, here's one. Oh, there's another. We might be actually at the right place, Dogmeat. Oh, and another. Yeah, but why is it in this, like, kind of secluded valley? Oh, look at that. Oh, hold up. There's people here. I guess the guy that we ran into was right. A place called Oasis. This must be it.
Outsider, you have arrived. Please, come closer. I have something of the utmost urgency to speak to you about. Do hurry. He doesn't like to be kept waiting.
Okay, that's a little too welcoming for my taste. But let's see what it is then.
I'm so glad you're here. It's been a while since anyone's visited us. And he's been waiting for someone like yourself to arrive. If you wouldn't mind following me, I'll bring you right to him.
Wait a minute. Who are you and what is this place?
I'm sorry. In my excitement, I got ahead of myself. I'm Tree Father Birch, and I have the great fortune of being leader of his people, the Tree Minders. Beyond that gate is our home, Oasis.
And who is waiting for me inside?
Why, he is, of course. If you'll just follow me to the pavilion, all will be explained.
Okay. Okay. We'll see where this goes. Lead on.
Excellent. Please, follow me. All will be explained soon.
Rejoice! The Great One wishes to see you. Welcome to Oasis, Outsider. We hope you'll find peace among us.
Wow. Now this is really something. The water's still irradiated though. That's odd. Irradiated water. With this mist green?
Hello.
Are you okay?
May you remain under the canopy of his protection.
You have no idea how overjoyed I am to see you. Normally, outsiders are forbidden inside Oasis, but he has made an exception.
I've never seen a place like this before.
No, I suppose you haven't. In fact, few who live outside of Oasis have. Everything you see around you, from the tallest tree to the smallest blade of grass, is a gift. A gift from him.
The way you are saying him, I swear you could be referring to some kind of god.
He's no mere god, my friend. He is the one who grows. He is the one who gives. And he is the one who guides. Thanks to him, the tree minders have a home.
I may be willing to help, but I need some straight answers about who he is.
I would have preferred that he made the introduction, but I understand your hesitation. The Great One is a god tree. A living, breathing, speaking god tree. The tree minders are blessed to have this being watch over us.
Why do you call yourselves the tree minders?
We care for this place and keep it safe from those who would seek to exploit it. He gives to us, so we give back to him. It's an arrangement that's worked well for almost 2 decades. We shun technology and embrace nature. That's the life of a tree minder.
If you hate technology, then why carry weapons?
Sadly, the wasteland is a hostile place, and sometimes we're forced to defend ourselves against it. If that means fighting with manufactured weapons, then so be it. Had he not asked to see you, you never would have gotten this close to the gates.
Which, I guess, brings us why I'm here, I suppose.
Yes, indeed it does. Sorry, I don't speak to outsiders very often, and I tend to get lost in conversation. As you approached Oasis, he said you were coming, and I was sent out to meet you personally with a request. He wishes to meet with you. You'd be the first outsider to do so in a very long time.
And where can I find this person?
Yes, person. To meet him, you must undergo the ceremony of purification. Once that's complete, you'll be able to speak to him. Whenever you're ready, we may begin.
Wait. What does this ceremony involve?
It's simple, really. You drink the sap from the basin here in the pavilion. The sap will purify your mind and body of anything harmful that could possibly hurt him. I assure you, nothing harmful will happen to you.
All right. Let's give this a try, then.
Very good. Take your place in front of the basin, and let's begin.
Dog meat, something happens. Attack them. Oh, great. All of them are just watching me. Here we go. Ugh.
We will now recite the blessing to ward off any harm the outsider may be carrying before he proceeds to the grove.
I bid you depart, agents of destruction, through the power of his divine will.
Leave our homes and bodies immediately. Live no longer in them, but pass over into places where you can harm no one.
In the name of his frondescence, I call his wrath upon you, so that wherever you may go, you bear it with you.
And, diminishing from day to day, you may disappear, except where you serve the health and good purposes of mankind. May no trace of you be found.
All this, may he be so good as to grant us, who is to come to judge the living and the dead, and the world by his verdure.
Amen. Soon, you will pass peacefully into sleep, outsider. And when you awake, you will witness his glory firsthand.
Okay, where the hell am I? Huh. They must have brought me in the grove. Alright, that's odd. All these trees have leaves, but that one doesn't. This one seems weird. The texture on the bark. Oh, that's why. Oh, wow. Is that an Ent? From what I hear in fantasy stories?
Glad to see you're finally awake. I can't believe they made you do that stupid ceremony. They listen when I talk, but they don't hear. You know what I mean?
Okay. Okay, this is amazing. Though I never expected you would have that kind of accent. This can't be a dream. I never met a talking tree before.
Neither have I. Well, I mean, I talked to Herbert, but he never really says anything back. Do you, Herbert? He kept growing around me. Maybe for calling him Herbert all the time. His name's really Bob. I think it's funny when I call him Herbert, though.
Wait. So you're trapped in there inside this Herbert? Bob? Whatever?
Well, I suppose you could look at it that way. See, Bob used to ride around on top of my head, sunk his roots right in there, you know? Well, eventually, he got bigger than me, and then I pretty much ended up inside.
How did a tree end up growing out of your head?
It was a long time ago. I tend to lose track. I was exploring some sort of a military base with some other people. I think it was called Mariposa. Mariposa. We were pretty deep inside and we found some weird vats of this nasty green goo. Right when we were about to leave, I think we were attacked. Yeah. Last thing I remember before blacking out was something knocking my friend into the stuff.
Okay, this all had to do with the green goo. More than likely radioactive. Okay, so the tree minder said you needed my help with something?
Yes, I do. Or, I guess, we do. Me and Bob, that is. I had you brought in here to ask a very simple favor. Would you please kill me?
Wait, what? You want me to kill you? You can't be serious.
Oh, no, 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 no. It wouldn't be murder. You'd be doing me a favor. You see, I've been stuck here for over 2 decades now, rooted right into the ground. The only friends I've got are Bob and those weirdos out there who think I'm a god.
But if I kill you, every tree minder will come after me.
Oh, no, no, don't worry about them. When you decide to go down there, I'll have a little chat with Birch and the rest of the gang. They usually don't understand a word I say, but I'll make them come around.
Why can't you take your own life?
Now, how exactly am I supposed to do that? I can barely move anymore. Thanks to Bob, I'm obviously not going to be doing anything for a very long time.
Well, if you lived like this for 2 decades, how do you eat? The tree must be completely a part of you. All right. How would I be able to kill you? You're a tree.
How to put this? I've been feeling rather spread out lately. I think Bob's kinda shoved my insides around some. It's hard to tell where everything is, but it's always that way with one's insides, isn't it? Anyway, I believe Bob's carried some of my organs into his root system. I want you to go underground and destroy my heart.
But I don't want to kill you. I mean, even though this is probably pretty awful, this is also pretty amazing.
Of all the wastelanders I had to bump into, it has to be one with a conscience. Let's keep it an open invitation then. I don't want to wait until the next person visits. It could be years. Just think about it, okay?
Okay.
No, no. Herbert is the tree. Bob is his real name, but I call him Herbert because I think it's pretty funny. But I'm still in here too. What's left of me? The name's Harold.
Oh, man. This place is amazing, but I guess I'm gonna have to do this.
Look, Herbert, she's back. I told you.
You don't actually seem sad, though. Why do you want to die? Is it that painful?
I've been literally rooted to this spot, thanks to Bob, for maybe 20 or 30 years. I can't even remember anymore. Can you imagine being stuck in one place for that long? Not being able to eat or to read or to sleep or anything? In the meantime, I have these tree minders bothering me every day about things I don't even care about! And I can't stand it anymore!
Oh, wow. Okay. I understand what you mean then.
I knew you would. That's why I picked you when I saw you coming.
How did you do that, by the way? Seeing me approach from Oasis. It's quite a feat for a living tree.
Maybe I'm just losing my mind from all this boredom, but I swear if I try, I can see all around me. Like my eyes are in every leaf, on every tree. I think it's making Bob kinda jealous, 'cause he was the first tree in my life. And all that.
Okay, so you can see from every tree. That means you're connected to every tree. All throughout the ground. I knew that they had some kind of way of communicating, but not in a way humans or animals do. How is it that you're causing all of these things to grow around you?
It's kinda embarrassing, really. Once a year, Bob decides he's gonna go ahead and start growing these weird pods filled with tiny seeds. Well, all it takes is a good wind and the seeds just fly everywhere. I call them Herbert seeds. He hates that.
I have some quick questions about that cave I just saw over there.
Yeah, I'll leave it to good old Bob to get me stuck above some caves. Now, my dang feet are cold.
Your part's probably down there, but how do I get in?
I think the best way for you to get down there would be to get the key from the one those loonies call Cypress. There's supposed to be some old gate or something back in the other grove.
Is there anything down there that I need to look out for?
Sometimes I feel stuff tickling me. But I think that's just Bob getting back at me for all the times I call him Herbert!
All right, then.
Okay.
I shall go now, then.
See you later. Well, maybe not if you do what I've asked.
All right, well. Well, it looks like we have to talk to some of these, well, people in order to get their opinion on stuff. Alright, let's see who we can find out. Oh, there's somebody's bed. Wow, this grove is so pretty though.
So you're the outsider, huh? You seem nice to me.
Any information that you can give me on the caves below the oasis? Anything would be helpful.
My parents told me never to go past the old gate. There are monsters in there.
Monsters. So tell me about your god?
Oh, you mean Harold? He's really nice. Sometimes when I get really lonely, I go into the grove and talk to him. Sometimes I even curl up all cozy-like and sleep next to his root after I have a bad dream. I tell him what I'm scared of, and he tells me what he's scared of. It makes me feel better knowing I'm not the only one.
Okay. Maybe if you tell me what Harold's scared of, I won't be scared either.
Aw, I never knew an outsider could be scared of anything. Harold told me that he's scared of fire. If fire ever got on him, it would burn him and Bob until they were all gone. That's why we keep the fires far away from him.
So how did you end up here?
I was born here, silly.
Okay. What did you have to do to become a tree minder, then?
Just get born, I guess. You're funny.
Alright, then I'll go.
Farewell, outsider.
This place... It's very nice to meet you, outsider. I'm Branch Tender Linden.
So, tell me about, Harold.
Well, I'm not so sure the Great One is a god. I mean... I don't believe in that sort of thing. However, I am beginning to realize he's special. Something greater than any of the creatures in the wasteland.
How did you end up here?
I was found dying in the wastes not far from here by a trader caravan. They knew about this place and brought me to Bloomseer Poplar. She nursed me back to health, and I've stayed ever since.
Dying? What happened?
I was a Brotherhood of Steel outcast. We had a deep patrol out here looking for some tech, and they got jumped by some Deathclaws. They shredded everyone else and left me bleeding to death. If it wasn't for Oasis and Bloomseer Poplar, I'd be dead right now. Honestly, I've never seen anything like this place. It's beautiful. It's a shame only a few people will ever get to see it.
What did you have to do to become a tree minder, then?
I sort of fell into it, I guess. I woke up here and I just stayed. After a while, I became one of them.
Do you know anything about the caves below Oasis?
Oasis is located near what used to be an old mining town before the bombs fell. When the attack started about 200 years ago, many people took shelter in the natural caves that dotted the area. The old gate that stands at the mouth of Oasis Cave is the last piece of architecture from those days.
All right, then.
Goodbye, outsider.
And I take
There's
it you must...
There's nowhere like this left in the world anymore. Oh, outsider?
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Bloomseer Poplar, soothsayer and healer of Oasis. It brings me great honor to welcome you.
Okay, so tell me about Harold.
He's not my god. He's everyone's god. You, me, everyone. This place isn't meant just for the tree minders. It's for all mankind.
So, what if there are others that don't share your opinion?
You'd think they'd realize that this place won't remain a secret forever. The caravans know about it, and you happened upon it. How long before someone comes to take this place by force? No, I say allow Oasis to grow, and that issue becomes moot.
So what's causing this place to grow?
In what we call the harvest month, the Great One creates seeds among his branches within seed pods. At the end of this time, the pods open and the seeds are carried quite easily upon the wind. It's quite beautiful. Wherever the seeds take purchase, they grow into trees, plants, grass, or all manner of wonderful things.
How did you end up here?
My father was a healer like myself. He had the most curious books I would read about trees and plants and their medicinal properties. Many years later, I heard a rumor about a place such as this. I spent a decade in search of it. I've been in this wonderful place for over 15 years now.
What did you do to become a tree minder then?
I was the third one to arrive here in Oasis. Tree Father Birch was a bit wary at first, but Leaf Mother Laurel convinced him to let me stay.
If she hadn't been around, I doubt Birch would have ever let me stay here.
After a while, they taught me their ways, and together we developed the ceremony of purification that you undertook.
All right, then. Do you know anything about the caves below?
Be wary of the water in the caves. I fear they still carry the sting of radiation from the bombs.
All right. Thanks for that.
May the Great One bless you.
Well, if that's the case... I wonder...
And I'm telling you, you've got it all wrong. Why else would he have called for an outsider's assistance?
The outsider is here to deliver us from our enemies, to keep this place safely locked away from the wasteland, not to exploit us.
How can we preach about peace when all you want to do is keep his gift all to ourselves? That's not what he would want.
If we allow the spread of this miracle to continue, we're putting him in jeopardy. I can't allow that. I won't allow it.
Once again, my husband, we are at an impasse. I suggest we speak to the outsider.
Agreed. Why else would the outsider have been allowed into the grove? Perhaps it's a test. Yes, that must be it. I know why you're here, and despite what my wife thinks, I know you'll do what's best for Oasis. After all, he chose you, and he would never want to put us in harm's way.
Okay. Can't we dispense with all the religious stuff? His name is Harold. He's not a god, he's just a human. Well, was human.
Oh, he's testing you now, just like he tested us. He wants to see if your faith is strong by spinning these incredible stories. Who else but a god could produce all of this? Don't worry, you'll soon see things as I do.
All right. Did you know that your god wants me to kill him?
Yes, I've been pondering that riddle myself for some time now, and I think I know what he's trying to tell us. The Great One's influence is growing, and soon it will break free of the confines of this secluded vale. We can't allow Oasis to call attention to itself like that. It would be the end of him.
Okay. Well, so what can I do to help?
If the same sap that you drank to purify yourself could be applied to his heart, it should stop the spread. I can promise you no harm would come to him. That's all I ask of you, outsider. Nothing more, nothing less.
I love Birch, but sometimes I think he doesn't see the big picture. The spreading of his influence is not a curse. It's a great miracle, a benefit meant for the entire wasteland.
Doesn't anybody care what Harold thinks?
Of course we do. He yearns to share his miracles with the whole world, to give the gift of life back to the dead wasteland. It's upsetting him to no end, but Birch can't see the pain it's causing. But now that you're here, I have a feeling the winds are about to change.
And you can say that. How can I possibly help?
I heard what my husband wanted you to do. What I propose is an alternative. The same person that created the sap also created this liniment. If you can reach his heart, it will assist him in making his influence increase. Instead of centuries, the wasteland will become green in mere decades. Just imagine how glorious that would be.
Oh, man. Oh, what a choice this is.
Branch Tender Cypress at your service. Welcome to our little home.
Okay, so what is your opinion about your leaders?
I wish they wouldn't argue so much. It makes everyone uncomfortable.
So how did you end up here?
I was an outsider like yourself, wandering the world aimlessly, wasting my life trying to seek my fortune. When my eyes beheld the splendor of Oasis, I knew I'd found a holy place. Pre-Father Birch allowed me to stay, and I've been here ever since.
Well, if I'm going to do any of this, I'm going to need to have the key to the caves.
Sure. Here you go. Good luck to you. May you remain under the canopy of his protection.
Oh, what do I do? Oh, what do I do? Now, where do I go? Gotta find his heart somewhere around here. Got that Meyer Lurk King. Oh man, where do I go? Do I actually have to go underwater? Okay, there's a path under the water. Hope you can hold your breath, dog meat. Here we go. Well, that wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. Oh, there's something wrong with my eyepiece. I still haven't figured out what keeps on causing it. Alright, I hear some... That sounds like a heartbeat. We must be here. Wow, his heart's actually kind of big. Oh, what do I do? Do I let it grow? Do I stop it? No, I can't do either of those two things. I gotta destroy his heart. That's the only way he would be at peace. Let's go, dog meat. Ugh. Holy crap, there's more of them. Careful. Oh, crap. Fine, then. I'll take out my big baby. Oh. Come on. No, no. I want the other king. Fine, then. If we're gonna do it... Oh. Nailed him right in the head. You know what? It's time to use one of these. Nuka-Cola grenade. Ugh. Where did we end up at? It's actually not that deep. It looked kind of deep.
The Great One is dead, slain by your hand. Don't worry, I hold no grudge towards you. You'll have to forgive my people at a time like this, outsider. They aren't used to being so lost. And for once, I don't have the words to help them.
I have to say, I'm surprised that you're not angry with me.
Oh. Before you reached his heart, he imparted his last words to me. He told me about his will to die and how I mistook this for some mystical sign. How could I have been so blind? How could I have misled all these people? Perhaps, if I would have spent more time getting to know him, things would have turned out different.
Maybe. Maybe. So, what do you think will become of this place?
Even though the Great One has left us, our memories of him will never die. With Bloomseer Poplar's help, I'm confident we can keep Oasis alive and carry on as Treeminders. Go now, outsider. Go, but never forget the gifts the Great One bestowed upon us.
I'm sorry, buddy. Had to do it. All right, Dogmeat. Let's go. Let's go home. Hey, what is this? He left me a little treat. A little gift. Now with Herbert's apple seed, you'll be able to grow my own apple tree in a planter box in Megaton. That was pretty nice of him. We get to make our own apples now. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed watching this Wolfed Out Fallout 3 video. Now remember to comment and subscribe if you so feel like it. Also check out my other LP series on my channel. Now if you want to know what kind of mods I use for Fallout 3, I put them in the description below. Now you guys stay furry, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye bye.